సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేయండి అండ్ ఫర్ మోర్ అప్డేట్స్ బెల్ ఐకాన్ క్లిక్ చేయడం మర్చిపోకండి.
స్టూడెంట్స్, నౌ వి ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు డిస్కస్ ద ఇన్ ఆర్ఎల్సి సర్క్యూట్. ఇన్ ఆర్ఎల్సి సర్క్యూట్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు డిటర్మైన్ ద రెసోనెంట్ ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ, రెసోనెంట్ ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ అండ్ క్యూ ఫ్యాక్టర్, క్యూ ఫ్యాక్టర్. సో ద సర్క్యూట్ ఆఫ్ ఆర్ఎల్సి ఇన్ సిరీస్, ద సర్క్యూట్ ఆఫ్ ఆర్ఎల్సి, ఆర్ఎల్సి ఆర్ ఎల్సిఆర్, ఆర్ఎల్సి ఆర్ ఎల్సిఆర్, బోత్ ఆర్ కరెక్ట్. ఇన్ ఆర్ఎల్సి సర్క్యూట్, ఆర్ఎల్సి సర్క్యూట్, సో ద ఆల్టర్నేటింగ్ కరెంట్ ఈజ్ ద ఈక్వల్స్ టు ఈ నాట్ సైన్ ఒమేగటి ఆర్ వి ఈక్వల్స్ టు వి నాట్ సైన్ ఒమేగటి. దిస్ ఈజ్ ద ఆల్టర్నేటింగ్ కరెంట్ ఈజ్ అప్లైడ్ ఇన్ ఆర్ఎల్సి సర్క్యూట, ఈజ్ అప్లైడ్ ఇన్ ఆర్ఎల్సి సర్క్యూట్. సో ఇన్ ఆర్ఎల్సి సర్క్యూట్, ఇన్ ఆర్ఎల్సి సర్క్యూట్ దిస్ ఈజ్ ద రెసిస్టెన్స్, దిస్ ఈజ్ ద ఇండక్టెన్స్, దిస్ ఈజ్ ద కెపాసిటెన్స్, దిస్ ఈజ్ ద కెపాసిటెన్స్. దీస్ త్రీ ఆర్ ఇన్ సిరీస్ సర్క్యూట, ఇన్ సిరీస్ సర్క్యూట్ దట్ సర్క్యూట్ ఈజ్ ద, దిస్ ఈజ్ ద రెసిస్టెన్స్, this is the inductance, this is the capacitance, this is the capacitance, this is the RLC circuit, this is the RLC circuit. First we have to apply the alternating current, we have to apply the alternating current. This is the E equals to E naught sin omega t. This is the R, this is the L, this is the C. This is the resistance, this is the inductance, this is the capacitance. So, in the magnitude of, in the magnitude of circuit, in magnitude of the circuit, this is the, this is the X suffix R. So this magnitude is the X suffix L, this magnitude is X suffix C, X suffix C. These three are magnitudes of the resistance, inductance, capacitance. So this is the circuit of RLC circuit, this is the circuit of RLC circuit in series containing, in series containing. Then we have to find the resonant frequency and Q factor, Q factor. So first of all, resistance of resistance reactance, this is the resistance reactance, resistance reactance X suffix R equals to R. Okay, this is the inductive reactance, inductive reactance X suffix L equals to omega L, equals to omega L. This is the capacitive reactance, capacitive reactance X suffix C equals to 1 upon omega C, 1 upon omega C. These three are reactants of resistance, inductive, capacitance. Okay, then we have to find the, first of all we have to find the impedance, impedance, impedance is denoted by Z, impedance is denoted by Z, but impedance formula, impedance equals to voltage upon current. This current is the maximum current. This current is the maximum current. And also Z is equals to voltage or potential difference. Voltage or potential upon current. This is the maximum current. This is the maximum current. This is the impedance. This is the impedance. But already we know that what is the maximum current. Maximum current means I maximum. I maximum equals to voltage V upon under root R square plus omega L minus 1 upon omega C whole square. R over R, I maximum equals to V upon under root R square plus omega L minus 1 upon omega C whole square. These two equations are equal. These two equations are correct. I maximum, this is the current maximum, maximum current. This equation already we know that in the previous sessions in LCR circuit we have to determine the total equation R plus L plus C is equals to E naught sin omega t. By the procedure of that equation is produced this maximum current equals to V upon under root R square plus omega L minus 1 upon omega C whole square, or E upon under root R square plus omega L minus 1 upon omega C whole square. This is the maximum current. This is the maximum current. But already we know that what is the impedance formula. Impedance formula, impedance Z equals to voltage upon maximum current. Maximum current. So these equations are in this equation substitute. So voltage means V upon I maximum equals to V upon under root R square plus omega L minus 1 upon omega C whole square. So this equation can be written as V into under root R square plus omega L minus 1 upon omega C whole square upon V. Then V is cancelled. Impedance Z equals to under root R square plus omega L minus 1 upon omega C whole square. This is the total impedance. This is the total impedance. This is the total impedance. So this equation is produced from the phase diagram. So phase diagram. So this is the phase diagram. This is the phase diagram. This is the resistance R. This is the resultant. This is the resultant. This is the impedance. So this is the X suffix L. This is the X suffix C. X suffix C. So this is the resultant. This is the impedance resultant. So here this is the total XL. This is the total XL. So this value is XL upon XL minus XC. This value is XL upon XL minus XC. XL minus XC. So this is the resultant vector. This is the resultant equals to by the vectors diagram. Resultant equal to r square equals to p square plus q square. P square plus q square. Then the equation here resultant equals to impedance z square equals to r square plus this value square xl upon xc whole square. So the impedance z equals to under root r square plus xl upon xc whole square. Already we know that z equals to under root r square. This is the inductive reactance. Inductive reactance equals to omega L minus capacitive reactance equals to 1 upon omega C whole square. So this is the impedance. This is the impedance from phase diagram. This is the impedance from calculation. So totally this impedance is produced from phase diagram. This impedance is produced from phase diagram. This impedance produced from the calculation of these circuit values. Anyway, the impedance equals to under root r square plus omega L minus 1 upon omega C whole square. Then we have to find the resonance. We have to find the resonance. Resonance. What is the resonance circuit? The circuit is said to be resonance. The circuit is said to be resonance if the current is in phase the applied voltage, the frequency at which the resonance occurs is called resonant frequency. Is called resonant frequency. The circuit is said to be resonance if the current is in phase the applied voltage, the frequency at which the resonance occurs is called resonant frequency. In the circuit what is the resonance? Here resonance clause is the impedance. The impedance of the reactive component is zero. The impedance of the reactive component is zero. Then it is resonance. It is resonance. So what is the impedance? Z equals to under root r square plus omega L minus 1 upon omega C whole square. This is the reactive component. What is the reactive component? This is the reactive component. This is the reactive component means XL upon XL minus XC. This is the reactive components. Reactive components means this is the XL, this is the XC. So the magnitude of the XL equals to the magnitude of the XC. So the total difference of XL minus XC equals to 0. So the impedance of the reactive component is 0. The reactive component is here omega L minus 1 upon omega C. The impedance of the reactive component is 0. Then it is resonance. So the resonance. What is the resonance? Omega L minus 1 upon omega C equals to 0. So omega L equals to 1 upon omega C. Omega L equals to 1 upon omega C. Then cross multiplication omega square equals to 1 upon LC. This L is here. This L is multiplier, this L is divider. So omega square equals to 1 upon L into C. 1 upon L into C. So omega equals to under root 1 upon under root LC. This is the omega. So what is the relation between omega and frequency? The frequency equal to omega upon 2 pi. Already we know that in the in the previous sessions and also in the intermediate classes, what is the relation between omega and frequency? Frequency equals to omega upon 2 pi. Omega upon 2 pi. Here frequency is the resonant frequency. Its frequency is the resonant frequency. Resonant frequency equals to omega upon 2 pi. So what is the omega? Resonant frequency equals to omega. What is the omega? Omega equals to 1 upon under root LC upon 2 pi. So resonant frequency equals to 1 upon 2 pi under root 1 upon 1 upon under root LC. So this equation can be written as the resonant frequency equals to 1 upon 2 pi under root LC. This is the resonant frequency. This is the resonant frequency. So what is the resonant frequency? The impedance of the reactive component is 0. Reactive component is 0. Reactive component is omega L minus 1 upon omega C equals to 0. So then omega L equals to 1 upon omega C. Omega square equals to 1 upon LC. Omega equals to 1 upon under root LC. This equation is substituted in frequency. So the resonant frequency equals to omega upon 2 pi. Omega means 1 upon under root LC. So total resonant frequency equals to 1 upon 2 pi into 1 upon under root LC. So the resonant frequency equals to the resonant frequency equal 1 upon 2 pi under root LC. This is the resonant frequency. So the maximum current flow, the maximum current flow at the particular frequency, this is the particular frequency, the maximum current flow at a particular frequency, the frequency is called the resonant frequency. That frequency is called resonant frequency. Then we have to find the quality factor. The quality factor is a measure of the efficiency of energy stored in inductor or capacitor. So this is the capacitor, this is the inductor. So quality factor is the measure of the efficiency of energy stored in an inductor or capacitor when an alternating current is applied. So the quality factor is defined as, the quality factor is defined as 2 pi times the ratio of the energy stored of energy dissipated per cycle. Okay, quality factor is defined as 2 pi times the ratio of energy stored to the energy dissipated per cycle. This is the quality factor. So first of all, the quality factor is the measure of the efficiency of energy stored in an inductor or capacitor when an alternating current is applied. So the quality factor is defined as 2 pi times the ratio of energy stored to the energy dissipated per cycle. So the first of all, we have to find the energy stored. Already we know that the energy dissipated per cycle. So the energy stored in electric field, between the plates of capacitor through the inductance. So the energy stored equals to of L I maximum square. This is the energy stored. Energy. Already we know that energy. What is the energy formula of mv square? This is the look like as this. Here mass is the inductance. V is the I maximum. So the energy stored equals to of L I maximum square. L is the inductance. L is the inductance. I maximum square. This is the energy stored. This is the energy stored. Then denominator term, the energy dissipated per cycle. The energy dissipated per cycle. The energy dissipated per cycle. The energy dissipated by the resistance, or I RMS square. I RMS square per cycle per frequency. This is the energy dissipated per cycle. Energy dissipated per cycle. The resistance I RMS square or I RMS square. That means root mean square velocity, root mean square current, root mean square current. So the energy dissipated per cycle is the resistance into root mean square current square upon per cycle, per cycle. So this is the denominator term. This is the denominator term. This is the energy dissipated per cycle. There's energy dissipated per cycle, per cycle. So this is the R I RMS square. RMS means root mean square current, root mean square current. So the quality factor is Q equals to energy stored. What is the energy stored of? First of all, the quality factor is 2 pi times energy stored is the of L I maximum square upon R I RMS square upon F. This is the energy dissipated per cycle. So this equation can be written as quality factor 2 pi times of L I maximum square upon R I root mean square elasticity square upon. So 1 upon F is the T. 1 upon F is the T. So this equation can be written as this equation can be written as this type. So quality factor is 2 pi times of L I maximum square upon R I RMS square upon F. 1 upon F is can be written as T, time period. So this is the, so already we know root mean square current I RMS. Root mean square current equals to I maximum upon under root. This is the formula. Root mean square velocity, root mean square current equals to I maximum upon under root 2. So from this equation, I maximum equals to I RMS into root 2. So maximum current equals to root mean square current into under root 2. So this equation is substituted in this equation. So quality factor Q equals to 2 pi of L. I maximum means I RMS into root 2 whole square upon R I RMS whole square into T. That is the quality factor. So the quality factor equals 2 pi under root of I square RMS root 2 whole square. this is the square, this is the square. So r I square rms into t. So here I square rms is cancelled, square root 2 cancel, 2 cancel, here if I get the L. So the total value Q equals 2 pi L upon RT. But here what is the, this is the quality factor, this quality factor Q equals to L upon R into 2 pi upon T. What is the 2 pi upon T? 2 pi upon T is the omega, because omega equals 2 pi F. So 1 upon T is the F. So omega equals to 2 pi by T. Omega equals to 2 pi by T. So then quality factor Q, the quality factor Q is equals to L upon R into omega. So the quality factor Q equals to omega L upon R. Omega L upon, this is the quality factor. This is the quality factor. So this equation also can be written as, because already we know that omega L equals to 1 upon omega C. Because the reactive component is 0, this is the reactive component. So therefore this equation can be written as this. So this value is substituted in this equation, the quality factor Q equals to 1 upon omega C. Okay, omega L plus, in the place of omega L, omega L is the 1 upon omega C upon R. So Q equals to 1 upon omega C R. This is the quality factor. This is also quality factor. This is also quality factor. So this is also quality factor. What is the quality factor? Omega L upon omega L upon R. This is the quality factor. This is the quality factor. This is the quality factor. And also, what is the, finally the quality factor is Q equals to 1 upon omega C R. So, but omega equals to 1 upon under root LC. From the equation of resonance frequency. Resonance frequency. So, the quality factor Q equals to 1 upon omega means under root LC. Quality factor 1 upon omega means 1 upon under root LC CR. So, this equation can be written as Q equals to under root LC upon CR. Under root LC upon CR. So, this equation can be written as quality factor Q equals to LC into LC upon CR. So, into root C upon root C. There is no change. There is no change. The value of this, there is no change. Under root C upon under root C. So, Q equals to under root LC square upon R C under root C. So, Q equals to under root L C. C square is the C. Upon R C under root C. Here C is the cancel. Remaining is the Q equals to 1 upon R under root L upon C. This is the quality factor. This is the quality factor. This is the quality factor of RLC circuit. In the term of quality factor, there is R, there is L, there is C. So this is the quality factor of RLC.